Hi and welcome. My name is Jonathan, and today we're going to talk about how to add video playlists to OBS Studios. Now, it is an insanely valuable feature that you could use that a lot of live streamers use, but not a lot of people are talking about. So stick around, and we're going to get a lot of value out of this video. Now, welcome to Entrepreneur's Toolbox. My name is Jonathan, and I'm here to help you find the tools to build an income online. And just remember, I put new videos up every single week, so make sure that you subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified every single time that I put up a new video. So first off, I wanted to talk about how to get the codecs or VLC onto your computer so you can make these playlists. Now, first off, just go to VLC, go to Google and search for VLC download. It's the easiest way to find it. So I'll just go right here. Google. And search for it. Now. There we go. So sorry about that. Now you just search for, I just searched for VLC download. The first result was the main page. This is videoland.org. Is the actual website. Sometimes it's hard for people to remember that. Just make sure that you're downloading it with the proper operating system. A lot of times it will recommend it. It will detect what your computer is and it will recommend it. Like right here, it's actually telling me Windows. So just make sure that you're actually downloading the correct one. I'm on a Mac, so I want to make sure that I get the correct version of the software for my computer. It's compatible with pretty much every single operating system. See, we got it down here at the bottom. You see all the different versions, VLC for Windows, Mac OS 10, was it Ubuntu? I'm not even sure what that is. Android, iOS. So basically anything that you need, you'll be able to use the software on that. So just download it free and just have it on your computer and even have it, you don't even need it to have it open to use it with OBS. It just needs to be on your computer. All right. Now, go. So, now what I'm going to show you is, so what you could do with with OBS, which I talked about this in some other videos, is you set up scenes. You set up scenes, and then in each scene you have a source. Now, here we go. So, this is my OBS layout. So, probably got that little funnel vision right now. So you have my main camera, which is this one. I just have it LS Cam 1, and then zoom in. I'll show you what that is. It's just like I have this, and then if I want a quick neural interrupt, I could have like a quick bump in. This is for my webcam, which is only 720p, so that actually, you know, degrades the quality a little bit more. But then I have the lower third, and so on and so forth, the desktop, which I just showed you, and you can create that, and I program them all into this software so I could have a quick switcher between them and not have to actually be on this page the whole time to switch between pages, since I don't have a second monitor hooked up at the moment. And then end card as well. But now I'm working on a second cam, but then here's test. Sorry about that. So you get the idea. I'm going to have to play that and you're going to have to see it because there's no audio. My audio won't play at the same time. So I'm going to just show you this clip. It just shows a countdown from 1 to 5, and then another clip starts playing where it's the same clip in reverse from 5 to 1. So we'll just show it to you and then it loops. Okay, so you see how it counted up and then counted back down because there's two clips and then it started to loop. So if you had any type of video file in here, then you'd be able to actually create that video or would actually be able to do that. So let me just show you, it might go back to it real quick. I'm gonna delete that and we're gonna build this exact playlist from scratch. Okay. All right. I think I figured out what I had an issue with last time that I streamed. So I'm just going to probably have to tell you how to do it because I realize that if I actually go in, or I might actually be able to show you right here, even though I actually created a separate scene, but if I click on that separate scene, I realize that it won't let me, it won't show my camera, so that's an issue. So I'm just going to show you right here under my camera, but then I'm not going to save it, and we'll just go back to the other one and use that as an example. So I'm going to hit plus, and you want to go to VLC video source. And then if you already have it selected, or you've already created this video source, you can just select it and add it in, or you can create a new. Let me just double check that you still can see me. Yeah, cool. So what you could do here is, let me actually do this. I realize there's actually one other thing. Here, this is better. So I'm gonna add it in here so you can see my screen. VLC video source, and I'm just going to create that. I actually just created this, so I was just talking about that, so okay. And so let me actually create a new one from scratch, sorry. VLC media source, I'm just going to create a new one, and it'll bring up this page, and then you can decide if you want it to loop, if you want it to shuffle the videos, and then also if you want it to stop when visible, which that means that when not visible, that means if you click off this file, then it will stop playing, and then restart when visible, and then you could pause it and then continue, or you could always have the video playing in the background and it just picks up wherever in the timeline that you click on it. So I like doing unpause when visible. So then you need to add in your sources, hit plus. You could either add a file or add a directory. If you add a file, it's just you add the individual files and add them in and they go right here. And then you could, if you want to reorder them, you just click to reorder them, however that goes. So if you don't want to do that, you could always add in a directory. What a directory is this whole folder that has everything. If I was to add more stuff into this folder, next time that I open OBS, it would actually add more, or I could replace everything and just have this as a live folder, and maybe it's a different video that I want per live stream, then I could just click on this and hit open. And then if I clicked okay, you don't usually build these things while you're live streaming. It's usually prepared ahead of time. But all right, I'm back. Sorry, I was just setting it up on the other side for the test, and you'll see, and I'll just play that real quick, and you'll see how it just goes. And I mean, I've already played it. Sorry about that. So you get the idea that all you have to do is create a directory or put your files in under a scene and then create the source, and then you can create as many videos as you want. So yeah, I was just curious, do you guys already use VLC for your, not just for live streams, just in general? A lot of people actually don't know what VLC is, and personally, I think it's the best media player out there because it covers pretty much every single codec. Let me know in the comments if you actually still use VLC. I'd actually really want to know because it seems like most people don't know what it is, but a lot of people do. So, all right. I'm going to be continuing going through my different things that I'm going to be doing with OBS and learning how to use it to live stream and these little features. Every single time that I upload or live stream, I want it to be a little bit better. And that's all that we really can ask for. We want it to be just a little bit better every single time, just a hair. So, if you want to follow me along my journey, I have a playlist. It's currently just called Live Stream Show. If you have any suggestions on what I can call this show once it's actually, got the ball rolling, just let me know in the comments. I really want to know what you guys think that I should be calling it. My first subject, as you can see, is, live streaming, teaching about live streaming, but I do want to hit up other topics. So if there is any other topics that you want me to hit up, let me know and I'll add them to the list, and that's what I'll tackle after I'm done with live streaming and kind of making this into a really nice setup. Let me see. And make sure that you like and subscribe to this subscribe and like this video. And again, let me know in the comments if you have any questions or requests. And if I'll put that link either up here or somewhere here for that live stream playlist. And I